and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
There are approximately 250 species of clovers found throughout the Mediterranean basin, Africa, North and South America, New Zealand, and Australia. Of these, 25 species are a significant source of feed for ruminant animals. Clovers fix nitrogen into the soil, improving its quality and reducing the need for nitrogen fertilizers. When planted with grass, this leads to the increased production of fresh grass for forage animals. That's why the plant is economically important in some agricultural systems. To date, few species have been scientifically investigated for human consumption. Red clover, T. pratense, is the most researched species for human use and is popular in traditional medicine. It's been investigated for its health benefits. In particular, it has a potential therapeutic role in treating certain menopausal symptoms, including hot flushes. White clover, T. repens, is gaining popularity within both human and environmental research. Research in mice has demonstrated that topical ointments made with white clover may speed up wound healing, while test tube research has shown that white clover extracts stop the growth of leukemia cancer cells. Although these findings hold promise that white clover extracts can be used as therapeutic treatments, more human research is still needed. In addition, white clover may also benefit the environment. For example, it's been shown to absorb heavy metals like lead and cadmium from the soil. Heavy metals prevent the growth of some plants. In humans, high exposure can harm the nervous system and fertility and increase the risk of cancer. Native to Europe, the zigzag clover, T. medium, is closely related to red clover. It is more tolerant to harsh environmental conditions than the red clover. Plus, it's being studied for its potential antioxidant and antimicrobial benefits, although research is only just emerging. Documented clover breeding studies began in the 1950s, with the aim of enhancing desirable traits such as drought tolerance. White clover has been used as the parent clover for many breeding programs, though genomes of other clovers such as the zigzag clover may also serve as the base for breeding. The suckling clover, T. dubium, is an example of an ISH clover. It's speculated that white clover is one of the earliest hybrid clovers. The rabbit foot clover, T. arvense, is an annual clover that thrives in sandy lands with little water. Similarly, the Kara clover, T. ambiguum, is adapted to harsh environmental conditions and is used to increase legume yield. The subterranean clover, T. subterranean, also thrives in poor soil quality and drought regions. It contributes the most to global livestock feed production. Clovers are a rich source of phytochemicals, predominantly the types called isoflavones and polysaccharides. These are anti-inflammatory plant compounds that have potential health benefits in humans. For example, they may minimize hot flushes during menopause and mediate cancer-induced inflammation and cell damage. Particularly, red clover isoflavones have been extensively researched. Meanwhile, the therapeutic properties of other clovers have limited evidence. Older studies have also identified quercetin and soesapinin as other phytochemicals in Trifolium species with potential health benefits for humans.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.